Welcome back to the second hour of Nightline. Oh my God, we had such a wonderful time on the first hour just talking to James Wiprut, and he was sharing about so many experiences that he have gone through in his young life and how the enemy was just trying to just take over his life. But one thing about it, we serve an awesome God who he sees what we're going through and he will meet us right at the point of our needs. I have a scripture that I want to share tonight. It's lifted from Romans 10, 8 and 9. And it reads, but what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith, which we preach, that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You will be saved. And tonight, again, our musical guest on the second hour of Nightline is Disciple 5, and they have been doing such a wonderful job tonight, and we are so blessed to have their music with us tonight because we know that they are singing songs that's straight from heaven. And thank you for calling in tonight. We have some amazing prayer partners out here, and they're always here to pray with you and to encourage you in your walk with Christ. Oh my God. And so always feel free to pick up the phone and call or tweet or whatever you need to do to reach us, because we are here for you. I have a scripture tonight that I want to share also. It's lifted from St. Mark, chapter 10, beginning at verse number 46. I want to read that tonight. And it says, and they came to Jericho. And as he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. Now listen to that word, begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace. But he cried the more, a great deal, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still. Oh my God, right there. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, be of good comfort, rise, he calleth thee. And he, casting away his garment, rose and came to Jesus. And Jesus answered and said unto him, what wilt thou that I should do unto thee? The blind man said unto him, Lord, that I might receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, go thy way, thy faith has made thee whole. And immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus in the way. I want to talk to you about that scripture in just a few minutes. But right now we're getting ready to go back to the Disciple 5, and they're going to be singing Jerusalem. Amen. Praise God.
City he saw, New Jerusalem. I want to rest on the banks of your river. In that city, city of God.
Wow, I am thankful tonight for such an awesome opportunity just to speak a word of encouragement to you, to hopefully by the Spirit of God that your hearts will be encouraged and lifted up, and that God will use you and bring you back to that place where He wants you to be. I read a scripture from St. Mark, the 10th chapter, and I read the 46th verse down to verse number 52. It was talking about a blind man. His name was Bartimaeus. And I read how he sat by the wayside begging. And when I read that, I thought about how many people today are just sitting beside the wayside, begging. But I also want you to know tonight that when the blind man Bartimaeus heard that Jesus was coming, he began to cry out to him, Jesus, Jesus, thy son of David, have mercy on me. Yeah, have mercy on me. And as he began to cry out, people that were around him, they began to tell him, hold your peace. Don't bother the master. And that really spoke to my heart, because so many times in life, we can find ourselves in a place that other people don't want us to come out of. And they will do everything, a lot of them will, to hold us back, to hold us down. But you know, you don't have to stay in that place. All you have to do is just cry out to Jesus. He hears your prayers. Prayers that sometimes you can't even speak verbally out of your mouth. Sometimes you have to just cry out from your spirit, Jesus, thy son of David, have mercy on me. And as he began to cry out the more, he got Jesus' attention. I want somebody at home tonight to hear and to know that you just got Jesus' attention, because he heard you. He heard you. He heard you. And I don't know where you are. I don't know what's going on in your life. I know that you're going through something. We all do. Not any of us are exempt in life from going through one thing or another. But thank God, can somebody at home say thank God? Thank God that we have a Lord and a Savior that we can call on any time of the day or night. You know, the other day I was making some phone calls from home, some business phone calls, and everyone that I called put me on hold. I mean, on hold, 5 minutes, 7 minutes. One time, someone picked up the phone and said, are you still there? And I said, yes, I'm still here. They said, hold on. They said, hold on, and put me on hold again. I said, oh my God. But one thing, when we call on Jesus, he doesn't do that. He doesn't put us on hold. In fact, in the book of Jeremiah 33:3, he says, call to me, oh my God, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not of. So when the blind man called Jesus, even though people were saying, don't bother him, be quiet, hold your peace, no, he cried the louder. I don't care what your doctor may be saying. I don't care what the prison guard may be saying. You cried the louder. I don't care what situation you're in. You cried the louder, because Jesus will hear you and he will come to your rescue. He will. I'm a witness. to that. He will be there for you. He will bless you. He will heal you. He will save you. He will redeem you. He will bring you out of a dark pit, out of the miry clay, and set your feet on a solid rock and establish your going. Oh my God, he hears you. You know what David said? He said, I was young, but now I'm old. Yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. The blind man was begging bread. He was asking alms for anybody that passed by. But when he heard Jesus was coming, Jesus changed all that for him. He told him to take off the clothes that he was wearing, those clothes that represented that he was a beggar. When Jesus comes into your life, you don't have to beg anymore. He says, ask, not beg. Ask, and it shall be given. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock. Come on, somebody at home, knock. And the door will open unto you. Oh my God, that's the kind of God we serve. And then he said, I love this verse. In verse number 51, he said, and Jesus answered and said unto him, what wilt thou that I should do unto thee? That's the question that Jesus is asking you tonight. What do you want him to do for you? What do you want him to do? He's there in your living room. He's there in your bedroom. He's right there in your hospital room. He's right there in your school room. He's there in the cell room. What do you want him to do? He's there. And all you got to do is open your mouth and say, Lord, be like blind man Bartimaeus. I want my sight. Oh, my God. I want to be healed. I want to be saved. I want to be restored. Revive my soul, Lord God. Revive me. He's asking you tonight, what do you want him to do? Because he will do what you're asking. Lord, I'm sick. Say, Lord, heal me. I'm going through something. I'm going through something in my mind. I'm going through depression. Lord, restore my mind. Revive my spirit. I'm hurt right now. Maybe you've been hurt by someone. God, heal me from the inside out. What do you want him to do? Don't stop asking. Don't stop praying. And don't stop believing. One thing about God, he will come to your rescue. I thought about the woman that was in Samaria. Jesus said, I have need to go through Samaria. Oh my God. I have need to go through Samaria. There's a woman there that she's going through something, and I want to speak life to her. When everybody else walked off and left her, when she felt like she was ostracized and put down and criticized, Jesus, I'm going to see her. I want you to know tonight that Jesus will come to where you are. He will. He will. He will come to where you are. And he will meet you right at the very point of your need. In other words, he looks beyond your faults. He looked beyond her faults. And he saw her need. Can I encourage you tonight? I know we're going through COVID. I know that a lot of people can't go to church right now. I know that people are hurting. They're lonely, depressed, despondent. I know that marital abuse is up. I know that people are, they don't know what to do. But I do know that we have a living Savior. And he's in our hearts today. And all you have to do is just call him like blind man Bartimaeus did and say, Jesus, can I get somebody at home tonight to say, Jesus? Call him. There's power in his name. There's healing in his name. There's deliverance in his name. There's peace in his name. There's joy in his name. There's hope in the name of Jesus. Can you just call him Jesus? Thy son of David, my Lord and Savior, the meek and humble lamb, have mercy on me. And he would do just that. So, Father, I pray for every person that's listening in tonight, that you will encourage their hearts tonight, that you'll lift them up, that you'll strengthen them where they're weak, and build them up where they might be torn down. In Jesus' name. Right now, we're going to close out Nightline with the Disciple Five, and they're going to be singing Midnight Cry. Amen. Praise God.
Sound of a mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now than it's ever been, and I can almost hear the trumpet. Midnight cry, we'll be going home. When Jesus steps out on a cloud to call his children, the dead in Christ shall see prophecies fulfilling, and the signs of the times, they're appearing everywhere, and I can almost hear the Father. Go and get your children.
when Jesus comes.